Now, we all know the modern world is united by two things, the Olympic Games and multinational corporations peddling us things we don't need. Yes, you may have noticed that the Rio Olympic Games are nearly upon us. It's an event that showcases elite athleticism, global unity, freedom, and junk food?
It's McDonald's Olympics Kids Program, bringing together children in the Olympic spirit of unity, understanding.
Yes, the major sponsors for the Olympic Games reads like a late-night shopping list of a stoner: McDonald's, Cadbury's, and Coca-Cola. As it turns out, these peddlers of obesity have been sponsoring the Games for yonks.
Hey! Hey! You're missing the game!
What you want is what you get.
Supersize
at McDonald's today.
McDonald's have been at it since the 1970s and Coca-Cola the 1920s. And now new research shows that the links between sport and unhealthy food and drinks in Australia isn't just for the elite. It's filtering all the way down to your local netball court.
Won't somebody please think of the children?
Research by the Cancer Council reveals that 8 out of 9 food and beverage sponsors of children's sports programs are unhealthy. 40% of children are exposed to Nestle's Milo through junior cricket. 11% are exposed to McDonald's through little athletics, basketball, and swimming. Overall, these unhealthy messages are reaching 1.25 million kids across the country. So what is the harm of this, really?
1 in 4 Australian children are overweight or obese, and a lot of studies have shown that food marketing is one of the contributing factors. And we certainly know that children are getting bombarded with a lot of unhealthy eating messages, whether that's through TV, but now we're also seeing it as part of these sports programs as well.
And the ways these companies are getting in our brains are very sneaky. With logos on websites, uniforms and sports equipment, and naming rights for entire sports programs.
The real danger of this, it's creating an insidious brand loyalty the kids take on through to adulthood without ever even questioning why.
But what if we did just ban the junk food sponsors? Who would fund all the fun?
The good thing about our study is that we saw that there were quite an array of different sponsors. Banks and airlines were sponsors. So we'd really like to see the junk food get out of this area and create more room for better types of sponsors that are not going to be having a harmful effect on children's health.
At the Olympic level, celebrity chef Jamie Oliver started a campaign in 2012 calling on the Olympics to dump the junk. But nothing has happened so far. So in the meantime, we'll continue to get fitspirational ads from our fatty multinational overlords.